one of the things that sort of sent me on a bit of a spiral after the Thoth video was where you talked about how he went to the Council of Luomong, was it something Luomong, and they created this Christos because the people wanted someone to worship. And obviously there's this whole thing with Jesus Christ. Do you think there was a real person called Jesus Christ, and what was his role and what was his real name, do you think?
Yeah, I was gonna make a video about it. I'm still working on it. It's so deep, what I want to explain that I haven't done, been able to get to it. But Jesus Christ, Jesus means something. Jesus, where they get the Jesus from, they say it translates from the Hebrew Joshua, right? But it really doesn't. Zeus, we know Zeus is a Greek god, right? Zeus, the element Zeus is in Jesus, right? Jesus. The Christ means Messiah or anointed. It's a Greek word, Christ, right? So when you go break it down to the Paleo Hebrew, you go really deep into the Hebrew. Hebrew, it actually means a deliverer, somebody who delivered his people or deliverer, And that's why, we try to go historic. That's what I try to do on my channel. And to my belief at first was that, Joshua was somebody important, the one in the Old Testament. And now we kind of know that he actually mo was the actual one they're using allegorically in the New Testament. He was the actual one. If you follow Joshua, he was actually the one that took over after Moses. He was blessed. He delivered the people to Jerusalem. And he didn't do it on a donkey saying peace to everybody. He did it with the sword. He went to these holy cities that they were living in, and he took them out. This is, scripture. And there's no movies about Joshua, there's a reason for that. Even Joshua means that there's a title. Joshua is a title. That wasn't the person's name. So we know Moses had kids and everything, so we're correlating all this stuff. We know, I see that Eliezer's one of Moses' sons, and I know there's a biblical Eliezer who was a commander under Moses and all that. He had the same attributes as Joshua, so we're looking into that. We're digging into that. But actually, to get back to your question, being a historical person, yes, we're talking about in America, most likely they're referencing Quetzalcoatl, as Joshua or Moses and stuff like that. So that's what we're trying to, dig into. All these things we know happened over here, so we're trying to connect who could have been, when it happened, and we know most likely in the 1100s, it seems to be a time when this historic person might have lived, 1000 AD, 1100s AD, going with a real timeline chronology, because even our chronology is kind of off.
Which chronology is best to follow? Because this is a question I'm just dying to know. Which timeline should you follow? Because that's what how they make it so confusing. Like, when was this in, when was, say, Noah's flood in comparison to what was going on in other per is that what caused the Atlantis to fall and stuff like that? It just these kind of things make sense when you have one timeline.
Is getting handcuffed here.
Ma'am, put your hands behind your back.
If you're going to be one of these people who's going to go out and not wear a mask, just lie when people come and say something to you about it. And you just say, not all disabilities is visible, you know.
Anybody try to tell me to take my eye patch off? Put it around my mouth? Tell them? Hook off, man. Hook you.